Ring the alarm, the alarm, the alarm, the alarm. Cause Babylon is falling. Yes, sir. Whoa.
Salud, my name is Toothless, Joy Verlander. We're the two co-founders of Kaweni Skate. Kaweni Skate is a collective, a like-minded collective of Owens from the Cape Flats. We are currently at location in Mitchell's Plain. Cape Flats, South Africa, Cape Town. If you Google it, it says, if you Google Cape Flats, it says one of the, it says the most dangerous community in the world.
Not relevant.
We've been, the 20 Skate's been in operation, or we basically formed on something that's a brotherhood. So, for the last 12 years, us as kids, we just started skateboarding together. Or separately, of course, started skateboarding and met each other on the skateboard. But it was always like in the community we grew up in, like skateboarding was never the like order of it. It was a sport, it was an option for like our peers. And then we come from different communities on the Cape Flats. The Cape Flats makes up for more than 50% of Cape Town. Mentality that didn't come to life, mummified, niggas passes nullified, take it in, be a man. Why am I still relevant? Maybe because I'm elegant. Mentality is ostracized, and the gang mentality is try to be in prison. Like that's what we are taught to, that's what we are taught as society, that gangs, criminals belong in prison. And for us to operate from a political perspective, they want us to say things like we don't support gangsterism and we don't support drugs, which is arguably maybe the like smartest people on the Cape Flats, you know. And we see the value in what they do. So we take that value of like, why is there a strong community of people dying that will die for each other, you know? We wouldn't die for each other. Normal people walking down the street won't die for each other, but these guys are dying for each other. And what is that? What's that common goal that will make them do that? And we take that common goal and put it inside what we do, inside our hearts, where each and everyone loves. School Turkish rope with no charm, cause I'm that charm to the ladies, alarm to busters around studios. And in turn, when those guys come up to us, when those gangsters, because our name is 20 Skate, so you can't separate the two and the eight, which is a strong gang mentality. The gang mentality on the Cape Flats 26, 27, 28, and it separated that way. 28 is the strongest, most feared, most notorious. And when these guys come to us and ask us about the 28, can I explain to them, or any of the members, because we speak unequivocally together, you know? And when any of the members answer these questions, these gangsters in turn say like, yo, but it's honorable, and it's great what you guys are doing. And they take it as a compliment to what they're doing, because the rest of society is just going like, get into your corner, get into your bars, stay ostracized. But we taking their mentality and showing them, yo guys, look, we are experiencing the best times of our lives. And we've been experiencing times that like other people don't experience, because it's men people in this world that has a common interest as a group for 12 years on end without any financial profiting from it, just because we love each other and we want to be together. And that in turn makes them feel positive about themselves. And most of the time, that's like the only positivity those guys ever felt for like how many years.
Well, I think one of the challenges in general that 20 Skate faces is perception. Not only in the gang community or the skate community or the general community, it's just because like skateboarding was perceived to be a white person sport. So on the Cape Flats, we weren't really welcomed by our own community, we weren't supported by our own community. Us being facing the aftermath of apartheid really adds so much more to perception, because our people on the Cape Flats were put in a system to think that life works a certain way, and this is how your culture works, and you are being put there. So we basically the voice of skateboarding, we question the things that wasn't questioned by our people, you know. And another thing for perception is changing the perception of skateboarders themselves, because if you told that you are this way or you should be this way for so long, you start to believe it. So we're changing perception of skateboarders and of general public.
We were very like gang involved, not gangsters as per se, we were called gangsters, but we were really influenced by what the gangs were doing, and we were friends and connected, and these guys would smoke buttons, and we would smoke clean tarry pipes with them, like clean only weed. But they would accept us because they're like, they really think that what we're doing is cool, because these are guys killing and like kniving and shooting each other, but they still have respect for like the element of skateboarding, because it's something that we're not doing for a profit, you know. We're not doing it so we can sell our drugs on the corner. We're just doing it for the enjoyment and involvement and being accepted by this community. So what I can say is we used to glorify these people. We used to see them. We used to look up to them definitely as role models, as like a positive role model, because they were the only people that we saw driving down the street with power. When I say power, I mean like they got money, they got cars, they got the woman, they got all the best things. And we perceive them as like something that we aspire to be. But now we realize that like we are the leaders, you know, and our voice and the fact that we don't have to negatively affect our community that we operate in. We realize that we are those leaders, and we look back at the gangsters and we say thank you. Thank you for like giving us the mentality that could actually take us to a point where we can't be stealing from our own people, you know, and that's what Twin Skate does. We take a style, we take a mentality, we take something like the Cape Flats, we do flat skateboarding, and we take that to the suburbs. And kids like this, because kids in the suburbs sit in their room, they play their PlayStation, but they're not exposed to things of the street, they're not exposed to carrying a knife because you have to protect yourself, you know. They're not exposed to Sabella because you must know what the Owens is saying. They don't know those things, and we do those things, and we do it on a skateboard which is accessible to everyone.